Hello and welcome. We hope you enjoy our program today. Please enjoy the show.
Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today is going to be a very chill and relaxed video. I'm going to be doing some concept work for my next children's book to get me into the circus mindset. So let's not waste any time and get right into the video. I'm going to start by making one of my favorite things ever, the carousel. See, I have a little carousel right here. Thank you. I love a good carousel. Actually, when I was in Thailand, there's this place called Carnival of Magic. It's in Phuket, and it is the most surreal, beautiful, otherworldly place. It truly doesn't even feel like it's on the same planet. It is so bright and colorful, and there's so many things visually going on. It kind of reminds me of like that place in Pinocchio. What is it called? Pleasure Island. It honestly feels like that. I say all that because I saw the most beautiful carousel in the gift shop, and I really regret that I did not buy it that day. It probably was really expensive, but I really want it. And if you see this carousel or anything that looks close to it, please send me the link. I will love you forever. I really need it. Like, I've been searching for it for like months and I cannot find it. So anyway, let's actually get started on the drawing now. Okay, let's start with sketching. I'm going to make this carousel kind of like a toy carousel, not too realistic. I want to keep it small so I can practice making little animals. And I don't want it to be too detailed. I want it to be pretty simple. One of my biggest style inspirations for this book is a really cute book that I found when I was in Bangkok. I went to a local bookstore with my friends and I saw this really beautiful book about animals making shoes, I think. It's all in Thai, so I don't actually know what it's about, but I just really love the bright illustrations and all of the animal designs and the maximalism on every page. I really didn't know at the time what kind of book that I wanted to make that would be kind of similar to this style, but I knew that it was something that definitely involved animals. And I think what I loved most about this book is the maximalism of it. I loved how every page had a bunch of animals scattered all around and they're all doing different things, and it's kind of like hard to focus on one. There's so many things happening, and I like that personally. I like when you can take the time and look at every single character and admire something about it, or notice something, you know, very cute and interesting, and notice little details. I think that's what could keep children especially more interested in a book, when they can go back and read it and discover something they haven't even seen previously. So that's one of my inspirations for this book. I also went to my local library and I found this really cool book. It's called The Midnight Fair by these lovely people. I'm not going to mispronounce their name, so you can read it right here. But it is such a beautiful book, and it has absolutely no words in it. It is completely pictures, and I love this concept. The idea that you can have this entire narrative with no words at all, and for the story to be really clear. The story is about these animals that sneak into a fair at night and go on all the rides and eat cotton candy and do all kinds of like cute stuff. But I think what really stood out to me was the illustrations and how vibrant and beautiful they are. The illustrator is actually a storyboard artist for movies, so that definitely shows in her artwork. You can definitely tell the person who made this has a strong understanding of colors and lighting and composition, and that's definitely something that I need to improve on when it comes to my own artwork for this book. I definitely want it to feel like every page is its own painting almost. So that's just some inspirations that I have for right now. For some reason, finding books about the circus is a lot harder than I thought it would be, at least in my local library. So if you have any recommendations of books that go along with this fair and circus theme, please let me know. I would love to check them out. I just want to get as much inspiration as possible, because honestly, I don't really know what kind of direction I want to even the narrative to go in. I just know that this is a topic that I really like, and so I am hoping that the story can kind of formulate itself, not just in terms of actual story narrative wise, but also creatively and stylistically. I have in my last Draw With Me video that I'm using a lot of like this kind of textured spray paint can, along with using vectors to block out and paint. I'm a texture girl, like I love having texture in my artwork, and I love my artwork to look hand-drawn even though it is not. And I feel like a lot of these like hatching marks and the spray paint texture kind of gives it that look as if it's been painted on a canvas or painted with pencil. You know, it's proven to be really effective and fun. I'm doing less work, which is like, oh my gosh, always my goal. I'm letting the actual tools and stamps help me out and do things for me, opposed to me just doing it all myself and creating all these little textures and details by myself. I'm also noticing I'm struggling a lot with drawing animals. You have no idea how many times I looked up how to draw a tiger when making this. I think there's just something about them all having different anatomy that really makes my mind buffer. So I really have to hone in and practice drawing animals if I'm going to make a book mostly about animals. I do get a lot of questions on how I get this really textured, hand-drawn look to all of my artwork, and that's really thanks to this rough paper texture in Clip Studio Paint that I kind of put on as an overlay on all of my paintings. I think it's supposed to simulate watercolor paper, so when you put it onto your actual artwork and then hit the blend mode, you'll get this really cool textured effect that makes it look a little more realistic. And I think that I am done. I like how it looks. I like that I added confetti. I definitely needed the confetti to kind of fill out the background a little more. And yeah. And there you have it. That is my first concept drawing for my book. It definitely showed me that I need to practice drawing animals a lot more. I'm definitely not comfortable enough with them yet, so probably in my next video I'll do a little more concept art for some animals and try out some different kinds of animals. But yeah, you know, we're just learning, we're just practicing and having fun. So thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and follow me on all my social media to stay up to date on what I am doing. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!